This comes after the launch of a 2022 annual crime report that indicated that crime volumes in the country had risen up by 18%. Giving his remarks during the launch, the Inspector General of Police, John Martin Zokoso Chola, attributed this sharp rise to a number of factors.
2022, we note that there was an 18% increase in the number of crimes reported to police, from 196,081 cases that was reported in 2021 to 231,653 cases, mainly due to the full opening of the economy after the COVID-19 lockdown and growing confidence to report crime to police. Out of the total cases reported to police in 2022, 68,405 cases were taken to court. 26,749 cases were not proceeded with, while 136,499 cases were still under inquiry.
This actually show a reduction of cases of defilement that were reported to negative 38%.
Ochola further pointed out that the force will in the year 2023 adopt a number of strategies to ensure that these trends do not repeat themselves.
Period under review, our focus has been on improving the quality of services we offer to the public in terms of enhanced law and order, engagement of communities through community policing programs, capacity building, and developing the initial phase of digitalizing our processes for purposes of easing detection, reporting, tracking, supervision, and analysis of crime trends.
The Director of Criminal Investigations, Assistant Inspector General of Police, Tom Magambo, highlighted that crimes of theft, assault, and domestic violence continue to increase.
So robbery is increasing by 30%. We saw homicide cases increasing by 3%. But of interest is also the narcotics.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, common traffic offences increased by 35% in 2022, while road crashes increased by 17%, from 17,443 crashes in 2021 to 20,394 in 2022. These crashes claimed at least 4,534 people, with pedestrians taking the lead, followed by Boda Boda riders. The Director of Traffic Police, Lawrence Niwawine, attributed road crashes to several factors. Niwawine, however, points out that they have already developed several strategies that will see road carnage reduced.
When they opened, we had people dying because tires would burst on the highways. And the tire burst killed 47 people and injured 199 people of tire bus. Why? The tires had expired and people were not conversant with the tire information, which now the traffic directorate has provided. And in case now you buy a tire, you must check the tire information so that you don't land into that problem.
Lucy Ladila Odoi, a technical advisor on criminal justice from the justice, law and order sector, also gave several recommendations to fighting crime in the country.
It's important that, one, we support the police in terms of its structures at all levels to make sure that we have efficient, effective and well-resourced police right from the police posts, that they are available to support, to respond and to address crime wherever it happens. But also working together with the other institutions, the prosecution, to make sure that the investigations are completed effectively and the cases are prepared for trial. Make sure that the judiciary is strengthened and provided with all the necessary support and resources to adjudicate these disputes. And all the way up to the end of the chain with the Uganda Prison Service, Community Service Program, who deal with not only the side of punishment, but also the side of rehabilitation.
Out of the total cases reported to police in 2022, 68,405 cases were taken to court, 26,749 cases were not proceeded with, while 136,000 499 cases were still under inquiry. This was an improvement compared to 2021, where 65,008 cases were taken to court, 60,095 cases were not proceeded with, and 70,978 cases were under inquiries. Rachel Nachwala reporting for the news.